I am Aditi Deshpande, belong to IIT Bombay X MIS team. As in previous sessions, you know, IIT Bombay X is a MOOC platform where the engineering courses are run for the engineering students. So basically what happens in a classroom? Teacher comes to the class, gives lecture and leaves. Sometimes you are physically absent or mentally absent in a class. So you are not able to get things. Sometimes it will be a tutorial class where the problem solving is done. Teachers gives assignment to do after a class and conducts exam. So now think of scenario where you will taught from a best faculty in a world in your own college or institute, and your own teacher tells you to watch video lectures and do assignments, and also the marks of the assignments are included in your final grade of the examination and also the evaluation of the teacher. This integration of the traditional classroom teaching and the MOOC course is called a blended MOOCs model. So advantages of a MOOCs course is the traditional lecture based video argue the more flexibility and accessibility to the student. They are accessed according to the time of the student, and at their own speed they can watch their videos, and these videos are given really by a very good faculty and expert in his or her field, so they are very efficient, and the length of the video is 5 to 15 minutes which students can focus on these videos more efficiently. And the quizzes and the practice problems in the online assessments are fully integrated with the course, and the instant feedback on that helps students to change their study style accordingly. It makes student independent by referring the discussion forum instantly when they are stuck instead of waiting for tutorial or go to their clarifications. Teacher focus their energies on interactive discussions and more challenging materials than regular classroom lectures and the homework assignments. In additional task for a teacher is to act as a facilitator. Means every week teacher has to collect data from student, get their MOOC marks and collate it and put it in a grading system. To reduce the role of the facilitator of a teacher, we introduce the information system for a blended MOOCs. It is popularly called as teacher's dashboard, where teacher will see student progress at a one point. There are three roles in this system. One is head, program coordinator and a teacher. Head will appoint a program coordinator and teacher. Head is a super user, and head will see progress of institute students. Program coordinator work is same as head, but he is appointed so that the head of the institute can delegate the appointment of teachers and view progress reports of institute student. Teacher will see the overall progress of student, and to view the progress of student he has to upload some data of student in the system. Now I will show you the demonstration of website. Now suppose I am a teacher from Ideal Engineering Institute teaching a demo course in a college, and I am logging in the system. After login, you will see these tabs. In a course detail, teacher will see the important dates for the course, like the enrollment start, end date, when the classes will start, evaluation policy, grading criteria, and the graded assignments. To see the student progress, teacher has to upload students' information. Information will upload in one particular format. For that, here the template is present. So you have to upload the data in a roll number, username and the email. Roll number is the student local roll number, and the username and the email is the IIT Bombay X username. When user registered on a IIT Bombay X, at that time username and email used by the students are teacher has to write over here. So I will upload one file. So here you will see total 18 students data present in a file. Number of students tagged in a system are 16. Here you will see two students will not get uploaded in a system as they gives error message. So here on the left hand side user manual is present. Here you will see what teacher has to do if they got error messages. As email is not valid, the teacher has to ask the student for the right email. So in the student details, teacher will see the details of the student, and he is able to edit the details of the student. Only the roll number is editable. After that, in the marks per problem, teacher is able to see how much marks a student get in each question of the quiz. As I selected the quiz 1, here total 10 questions are there. Out of he will see question 1 has a 4 marks, question 2 has a 4 marks. How much students have attempted the question 1, 2 accordingly that, and how much marks they get. Everything is downloadable and it will download at a CSV format. In the summary of marks, teacher will see the overall progress of the student. Likewise, the as you see, Alan gets 0 marks, so teacher will see he gets a 0 mark in quiz, in overall performance. Now suppose your institute is participating in multiple courses in a blended MOOCs, so and they have multiple teachers, so here comes the role of program coordinator. Suppose Jay Sharma is the program coordinator for the institute. Here you can see this institute is enrolled for the two courses, DC101 and SCANI101. So this is for the program coordinator. He will see the overall progress of the institute. He also able to enroll the new teacher for the institute. Now you can see the for DC101 there are two teachers. Program coordinator will see the same as per head will see. Only the program coordinator is not able to upload the student's data. He will only see the progress of the student. And same dashboard will be seen by head. Thank you.
Why are you in foreigners?
It's just example, sir.
Yeah, but you already have
Yes. Okay. From next time I will do that.
Next time, where are you getting the model?
Sir, it's duplicate data. It's not real data.
I know, but where did you get those names?
Yeah, they're not common names also.
So data kahan se click kiya? No, but all of you attended the MOOCs, no? Most of them have.
Okay.
So I have a basic question. Since you people have attended all these MOOCs, would it actually help if there's somebody who at the end of every week, okay, a physical one-on-one discussion session? It will help in learning? You should get a survey done to check whether Dr. Phatak's theory is correct. Okay. I don't know. I don't require. Okay. Well, I got huge fights with Dr. Phatak. I also asked him, why should I look at your lecture? I can take computer science programming lecture from somebody else, no, who might be a better teacher. So all this best teacher and all that, I don't believe. There is no best teacher. Best teacher is somebody whom I like, his style of teaching. Now, most of you think probably that this is best because of the accent. Okay, so most of the US people have got a different accent, but you can get used to it if you watch movies.